principal, teachers and my dear students. I am here to present a welcome speech for Independence Day. Today, it's our 75th Independence Day and we should feel proud to be a part of an independent nation that has freedom of speech, freedom to live life in our own way. We do not have to follow anybody's slavery. India has been ruled by British for almost 200 years, and after continuous struggle by our freedom fighters, us, we achieved independence on 15th August 1947. On this day, the national flag was hoisted on Red Fort in Delhi by Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru. Since then, we are celebrating Independence Day in every government schools and colleges. This is a day of pride and joy for every citizen of the country. I wish all of you have a happy Independence Day. Thank you. Jai.
പ്രത്യേകത ഉൾക്കൊണ്ടുകൊണ്ട് നല്ല രീതിയിൽ വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം ചെയ്ത് നല്ല പൗരന്മാരായിട്ട് മാറേണ്ട ഉത്തരവാദിത്വം നിങ്ങളിലുണ്ട്. ഈ അവസരത്തിൽ എനിക്ക് നിങ്ങളോട് ചോദിക്കാനുള്ളത്, സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം എന്നാൽ എന്താണ് നിങ്ങൾ അതുകൊണ്ട് അർത്ഥമാക്കുന്നത്? നമ്മുടെ ജീവിതത്തെ, ജീവിതങ്ങളെ നന്നാക്കാൻ നമുക്ക് അവസരങ്ങൾ നൽകുന്നതാണ് ഇത്. ഉത്തരവാദിത്വബോധമുള്ള, ചുമതലാബോധമുള്ള, സത്യസന്ധതയുള്ള, പൗരബോധമുള്ള, രാജ്യസ്നേഹമുള്ള ഒരു തലമുറ വളർന്നു വരേണ്ടതിന്റെ ആവശ്യകതയെ കുറിച്ച് നിങ്ങൾ ചിന്തിക്കുകയും നിങ്ങളുടെ ഉത്തരവാദിത്വങ്ങൾ നല്ല രീതിയിൽ നിറവേറ്റിക്കൊണ്ട് ഈ ലക്ഷ്യത്തിൽ എത്തിച്ചേരുന്നതിനും നിങ്ങൾക്ക് സാധ്യത ഒരുക്കുന്നതാണ് സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം. Give the best and shine wherever you are. ഈ അവസരത്തിൽ, ഈ കൊറോണ കാലഘട്ടത്തിൽ വീട് വിദ്യാലയമാകിയ വിദ്യാലയമായി മാറിയ കാലഘട്ടത്തിൽ ഞങ്ങളുടെ എല്ലാ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങളിലും ഞങ്ങളോട് സഹകരിക്കുന്ന പ്രിയപ്പെട്ട ടീച്ചേഴ്സിനും ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രിയപ്പെട്ട മാതാപിതാക്കൾക്കും ഏറെ പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഞങ്ങളുടെ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങൾക്കും എല്ലാം നന്ദി രേഖപ്പെടുത്തുകയാണ്. കൃതജ്ഞതയോട് നിങ്ങളെ രാവിലെ ഓർമ്മിക്കുകയാണ്. മുന്നോട്ടുള്ള യാത്രയിൽ നമ്മൾ ഒന്നിച്ച് ഒരു മനസ്സോടെ നമുക്ക് മുന്നേറാം. അങ്ങനെ ഒരു നവഭാരതം കെട്ടിപ്പടുത്തേണ്ടതിന് ആവശ്യമായ കാര്യങ്ങളിൽ നമുക്ക് വ്യാപൃതരാകാം. ഓൾ ദി ബെസ്റ്റ്. ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടി ഈ ദിവസത്തിന്റെ എല്ലാ ആശംസകളും നിങ്ങൾക്ക് നൽകുന്നു. നന്ദി. ജയ്.
Let me wish you all happy Independence Day. On 15 August 1947, we got independence from British rule. We should celebrate this day and with great spirit. We should remember Gandhiji and Nehru and others. Be proud to be an Indian and thank you. Jai Hind.
Symbol of freedom and unity. unity of the country. It is rectangular in shape. Since it has three colors, it is so called as tricolor or tricolor.
Unity in diversity is the most important feature of our country. Keep your fingers crossed and just watch the performance of our little ones of standard 3rd and 4th in the traditional dress of different states.
The salt satyagraha, also known as Dandi March, as an act of non-violent civil disobedience in colonial India led by Mahatma Gandhi. The Congress session held at Lahore in 1929 decided to launch the civil disobedience movement under the leadership of Gandhiji. The aim of the movement was to disobey the unjust laws imposed by the British government. The Indians had to pay huge tax for making salt. The tax was a heavy burden for the poor people. Gandhiji realized that salt can be used as a weapon to organize a stronger mass movement. He decided to disobey the salt law. Accompanied by 78 followers, Gandhiji set off from the Sabarmati Ashram and reached Dandi by marching 375 km on foot. On 6th April 1930, Gandhi broke the salt law by making salt, and he launched the civil disobedience movement by taking a handful of salt. Let's hear what Titus G, one of the Malayali participants of the Dandi March, has to say.
Gandhi started the salt march with 78 of his trusted volunteers. I am also one among them. The march spanned 375 km from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi. Many joined us along the way. Gandhi broke the British salt laws at 6:80 a.m. on 6th April 1930 by making salt. It sparked large-scale acts of civil disobedience against the salt laws by millions of Indians.
അതിരിൽ ചിന്തിയ രക്ത കണങ്ങൾ Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, properly known as Mahatma Gandhi, is regarded as the father of nation. Gandhi was a social reformist and leader of Indian independence movement who introduced the idea of non-violent resistance called Satyagraha. Mahatma Gandhi is widely recognized as one of the 20th century's greatest political and spiritual leaders.
Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, B.M. Rao Ramji Ambedkar, also known as Baba Sahib Ambedkar, is famous as the father of the Indian Constitution. He was a great activist and a social reformer who fought for the rights of Dalit and upliftment of the society backward class in the Indian society.
Annie Besant. Annie Besant was a prominent British theosophist and reformer who was a supporter of Indian independence. She established the famous Theosophical Society in India. She became interested in Theosophy, a religious movement founded in 1875 and based on Hindu ideas of karma.
Bal Gangadhar Tilak, born as Keshav Gangadhar Tilak, was an Indian nationalist, teacher and an independence activist. He was one third of Lal Bal Pal triumvirate. Tilak was the first leader of Indian independence movement. The British colonial authorities called him the father of Indian unrest. He was also conferred with the title of Lokmanya, which people means accepted by the people as their leader. Mahatma Gandhi called him the maker of modern India.
Sarojini Naidu was an Indian political activist and poet, a proponent of civil rights, women's emancipation and anti-imperialistic ideas. She was an important figure in India's struggle for independence from colonial rule. Naidu's work as a poetess earned her the sobriquet "The Nightingale of India" or "Bharat Kokila" by Mahatma Gandhi because of color imagery and lyrical quality for her poetry.
Akkama Cherian was an Indian independence activist from Kerala. She was popularly known as the Jhansi Rani of Travancore.
Thank you. जनगणमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे